Breaking right now in a Seminole County courtroom. Half a dozen defendants in those internet cafe raids are facing a judge. The national head of the Allied Veterans of the World, which ran dozens of those now outlawed cafes, has struck a deal to avoid jail. WESH 2's Greg Fox is live outside the Seminole County Courthouse in Sanford. Greg, what are the details of this plea?
Well, many people would look at this deal, Jason, and say this is a very, very good deal for Jerry Bass, who was the commander of the Allied Veterans of the World, which was shut down earlier this year, along with internet cafes across the state. He will get no jail time, no probation. He will have no felony criminal record, and in exchange, he will testify for the state at future trials. Now, this morning, WESH 2 News caught up with Bass as he was sitting outside the courtroom in the plea deal that was arranged by his attorney and accepted by the special prosecutor in this case. He entered a plea of guilty to two of the 200 counts he was potentially facing, including operating an illegal lottery.
Mr. Bass is a 63-year-old man who's been a pillar of the Jacksonville community for a number of years. I think that what caused him some concern early on was the fact that for years they believed that these enterprises were legal. They met with a number of individuals who were prominent within the state government, both in the Agriculture Department as well as Governor Rick Scott, Attorney General Pam Bondi.
You'll recall it was back in March that state agents raided some of the 40-plus internet cafes run by Allied Veterans of the World. 57 people were handcuffed on hundreds of charges of conspiracy, racketeering, and running illegal gaming operations at the cafes where people would play on slot-like machines. The charity operated roughly four dozen internet cafes, but investigators say most of the $300 million raised benefited very few veterans' causes. You'll also recall that the raids led to the resignation of Lieutenant Governor Jennifer Carroll. That post has not been filled by Governor Rick Scott as yet. Carroll worked for Allied Veterans. We'll have much more as these cases continue to be heard here in the Seminole County Courthouse later on WESH 2 News and on WESH.com. Live in Sanford, Greg Fox, WESH 2 News.